The St. Regis Parish family gathers to celebrate the fourth and last Sunday in the season of Advent. There is one announcement. We will be decorating our church this Thursday evening, December 22nd, beginning at 5 p.m. Everyone is invited to join in the seasonal fun as we prepare our worship space to celebrate the Savior's birth. Pizza and pop will be provided. That's Thursday at 5 p.m., church decorating. Please pick up the hymnal and turn to number 460, People Look East, number 460. People look east, the time is near of the crowning of the year. Make your house fair as you are able. Trim the hearth and set the table. People look east and sing today. Love, the guest is on the way. Furrows be glad, the earth is bare. One more seed is planted there. Give up your strength, the seed to nourish, that in course the flower may flourish. People look east and sing today. Love, the rose is on the way. Birds, though you long have ceased to build, guard the nest that must be filled. Even the hour when wings are frozen, now for fledging time is chosen. People look east and sing today. Love, the bird is on the way. Stars keep the watch when night is dim. One more light the bowl shall brim. Shining beyond the frosty weather, bright as sun and moon together. People look east and sing today. Love, the star is on the way. Angels announce with shouts of mirth, Christ who brings new life to earth. Set every peak and valley humming, with the word the Lord is coming. People look east and sing today. Love, the Lord is on the way.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, indeed the Lord is on the way. As we come together, beginning this final week of our Advent journey, we know that the celebration of the Lord's birth is near, and we are called to open our hearts ever more fully to His coming. As we prepare ourselves for this celebration, let us call to mind our sins, those times that we have closed our minds and our hearts to God's grace and love. And let us call on our merciful God for pardon and peace. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask for the sign from the Lord your God. Let it be deep as a nether world or high as the sky." But Ahaz answered, I will not tempt the Lord." Then Isaiah said, "Listen, O house of David, is it not enough for you to weary people? Must you also weary my God? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel." The word of the Lord.
Lord, let us see your kindness. 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 Let us hear what our God proclaims. Peace to the people of God. Salvation is near to the ones who fear and truth, justice and peace. Truth shall spring up as the water from the earth. Justice shall reign from the heavens. Lord, let us see your kindness. Justice shall walk in his pathways. Salvation, the gift that he brings. Lord, let us see your kindness. Lord, let us see.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Paul, a slave of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised previously through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, the gospel about his son, descended from David according to the flesh, but established as Son of God in power, according to the Spirit of holiness through resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, we have received the grace of apostleship to bring about the obedience of faith for the sake of his name among all the Gentiles, among whom are you also, who are called to belong to Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When I start my homily preparation every week, I try to take at least a little bit of time with the scriptures at the beginning of the week and look through them and see what jumps out at me as a starting point to put together a theme. And a couple of things jumped out at me at the readings that we hear on this fourth and final Sunday of Advent. One is the appearance of Saint Joseph. We don't hear very much from him in Scripture. He only makes a couple of very brief appearances. And when Saint Joseph appears, as we hear in the Gospel tonight, he never says anything. We do not have any recorded words of Saint Joseph in the Gospels. But Matthew tells us that he is a righteous man. He's seeking to do what is right and just, to be a faithful son of Israel, to be faithful to the covenant, to do what God is calling him to do. And he's in a dilemma when it is discovered, when he discovers that Mary is with child. He is a righteous man, and according to the law, child conceived out of wedlock, the woman could be put to death. But yet he's unwilling to expose her to the shame, and so he has a plan to divorce her and separate himself from the situation quietly, trying to find the right balance and do the right thing. But then the angel of the Lord appears and speaks. And Joseph listens. Joseph is the ultimate example of the strong, silent type. He doesn't say anything, but he listens and does as God is calling him to do. As we gather on this final weekend before Christmas, this is a time that is a very busy time of year. I remember watching one of those Channel 13 documentaries about all those places down in the Strip at Christmas time. The Saturday before Christmas, that'd be today, is one of the busiest days down there. Everybody goes down for their fish. All the Italian families go down there for their fish and everything else. We're busy buying fish and ham and everything else that we buy. I've heard this week a lot of people are baking and doing all this stuff, still buying gifts. I saw in the newspaper the other day, Westmoreland Mall is busy. I see the Amazon truck buzzing around Trafford all the time. Gone out 1:30. I've been going to penance services this week, and I got behind that Amazon truck every day. We're all very busy at this time of the year. But as we come together in these final days of Advent, I would humbly suggest that we follow the example of Saint Joseph and we take some time amidst all of the rush in these final days to listen. Our world is a very noisy world, even more so at this time of the year. Physically noisy, there's lots of noise, there's lots of spiritual noise. And so we need to take the time to quiet down as much as we can, whenever we can, and listen. And the other thing that jumps out at me as we hear these readings tonight, we hear again and again of Emmanuel. God is with us. The prophecy of Isaiah tonight in the first reading came several centuries, more than 700 years before the birth of Christ. And it's a prophecy to Ahaz, speaking of political turmoil in the time in which King Ahaz lived. And all of those details are not important, but what is important, the vision or the promise, the sign that God promises through Isaiah to King Ahaz and the people of Israel, it's a sign that God will be with his people. As they dealt with their uncertainty in their time, that was the meaning of what the Isaiah prophesies tonight. God will be with his people even in turmoil. We as Christians see that fulfillment in the coming of Jesus. Matthew takes those words of Isaiah tonight as the angel appears to Joseph. The birth of this child will save people from their sins. God is with us. Now, I spent a lot of time hearing confessions this week at penance services. I was over there for an hour and a half today hearing confessions today. We still have more penance services to come. And as I've listened to confessions during the course of this week, as I always do at this time of the year, everybody's coming from whatever our experience is right now. For many of us, we have estrangement in our families. We have stresses in our families of various kinds. Some of us are stressed over work or lack thereof. It's lots of pressure. And sometimes it can seem like God is far away. Sometimes in our individual lives, we're struggling with whatever it is that we struggle with in terms of our sin and temptation. I hear from people all the time, they say, "Father, every time I come to confession, I confess the same things. I'm struggling with the same stuff." Whether we're struggling internally, whether we're struggling in our families, as we struggle sometimes in our community to deal with the issues that confront us as a community or as a country or as a church, we take hope and strength in Emmanuel. God is with us. We approach the sacrament of reconciliation broken because of our sinfulness. God is with us, is there to heal us. When we turn to God in prayer with whatever it is that's going on in our lives, we turn to Emmanuel. God is with us. As we confront challenges, whether they be our own personal challenges or whether they're struggles in our families or challenges in our world, we have recourse to Emmanuel. God is with us. And as we approach Christmas this year, we look forward to celebrating jubilantly. God is with us. And so in the midst of all of the hustle and bustle of these final days before Christmas, as we do our shopping and finish our decorating and do the baking and welcome our loved ones and all the other things that we have to do, with all the noise, physical and spiritual, that's out there in our world, let us look to the example of Saint Joseph as we prepare ourselves this week to find time for some quiet and just listen. Be in the presence of the one who has come to save us, to save his people from their sins. Emmanuel, God is with us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord is King. Let us allow him to enter our hearts with our prayers for the world.
The response is, come, Lord Jesus. For the church, as we proclaim that God is with us forever and always, we pray, come, Lord Jesus. For all nations, especially Ukraine and Russia, that they may coexist in loving peace, and that attitudes of hatred and greed may be overcome by love and mercy, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus. For those who find it difficult to celebrate at this time of year because of loneliness, conflict, loss, or other hardships, that they may find comfort in God's abiding presence, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus. For our parish, that we may actively invite young men and women in our midst to share their gifts and energy as priests, deacons, or members of vowed religious orders, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus. For all of us preparing for the coming of Christ, that the kindness and generosity we show at Christmas may take root and remain active in us throughout the year, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus. For our beloved dead, may they be welcomed in the fullness of God's kingdom, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus. During this Mass, we remember in a particular way Brian Casper, we pray. Come, Lord Jesus, for the prayers we hold deep in our hearts, which we now pause to add.
Father, all-powerful God, your eternal word took flesh on our earth when the Virgin Mary placed her life at the service of your plan. Lift our minds in watchful hope to hear the voice which announces his glory, and open our minds to receive the Spirit who prepares us for his coming. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our presentation hymn is number 981. Stainless the Maiden, number 981. Stainless.
world of brightness, comfort for the dying. Eyes she is holding for a world adoring. Hope of the nations, Jesus Christ our
pray, my brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when at last he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Regis and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus has taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold the one who has come to take away the sins of the world and whose return in glory we await. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 804, Here I Am, Lord, number 804. Of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save.
I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright, who will bear my light to them, whom shall I send? Here I you
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a couple of quick notes. You may have noticed the family Christmas tree made it here this week. It is over there. I see a few ornaments already on it. If you left your ornament from last year, it's packed away, so more decorating this week. All those ornaments will be added to the tree. If you've not yet, family doesn't have an ornament on the tree, especially I invite our newer families who have been joined us over the last year or two to participate in our little custom of putting an ornament on the tree to represent your family, to be there throughout the Christmas season. As mentioned before Mass, we'll be decorating on Thursday evening starting at 5 o'clock. Work usually goes pretty quick, so invite you to come and spend a little time, have a little fun as we get the church ready for Christmas, and pizza, pop, and chips will be provided. Next weekend, of course, is Christmas. It falls on a Sunday, so actually, our Christmas schedule is very similar to our weekend schedule. The only thing is we add a midnight Mass. So next weekend, we have the vigil at 5 o'clock, we have Mass at midnight, and a Christmas morning at 9:30. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing, and please respond to each invocation with a hearty and heartfelt Amen. You believe that the Son of God once came to us. You look for Him to come again. May His coming bring you the light of His holiness and free you with His blessing.
Amen.
May God make you steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and untiring in love all the days of your life.
Amen.
You rejoice that our Redeemer came to live with us as man. When He comes again in glory, may He reward you with endless life.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. Our closing hymn is number 466, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel, number 466.
Sinai's heart in ancient times did give.